Quick thing before we dive in, since most of us are night owls who live online and rarely see daylight, I thought, why not build the greatest cybersecurity community this world has ever seen? A place where brilliant hackers come together, support each other, and learn as a team. We've got full courses, endless resources, answers to all your questions, and a crew that's here to make sure you're never alone on this journey. Come join us. Links in the description. Alright, today we're diving into a topic that's got some of us a bit paranoid. Links. You know, like when you accidentally click on a sketchy link and suddenly wonder if you're about to get hacked into next Tuesday. Let's talk about whether clicking a link alone can actually compromise your security. So by just clicking a link, I mean you click it, don't download anything, and don't fill in any forms. Can anything bad actually happen? Short answer. Sort of, but not quite the way you might think. First, some reassuring news. Most modern browsers don't let websites run dangerous code on your computer like they did back in the ActiveX era. But there are still ways sites can collect info on you. For example, a site could use a tool like Grabify to learn a lot about you without you even noticing. Let's say I put my YouTube channel URL into Grabify, click Create URL, and voila, now I've got a tracking link. Now I'm using a VPN here, always a good habit, but let's click on this Grabify link and see what it shows me on the back end. I get a fake Cloudflare notification, very sneaky, and then it directs me right to my YouTube channel. A typical user might not even realize anything happened. And yeah, Grabify just collected details on me. Browser info, my OS. Even my IP if I wasn't using a VPN. Sneaky, huh? Speaking of VPNs, here's a fun twist. Even if you're using one, Grabify can still grab other details like your browser, OS, and sometimes even things like your battery level on mobile. If you're looking for serious privacy, there's a cool option called the Mullvad browser. It's free, works with any VPN, and doesn't spill nearly as much info to websites as most browsers do. It's basically Tor browser without the Tor network. To be extra sneaky, Mullvad uses weird window sizes and other tricks to make it harder to fingerprint. Alright, let's get to the scarier side of things. Is it possible to have actual code run on your machine from a single click? The short answer is yes, but it's rare and mostly happens with high-stakes targets like, say, government officials. For example, North Korea has occasionally managed to exploit zero-day vulnerabilities in Chrome. This is where a website, with some very specialized code, can run native machine code right on your computer. If you're using Windows, it's worth noting that Windows has some solid protections in place to make it hard for anything to escape its browser sandbox. Mac's integrity protection is even stronger, and Linux, well, unless you're manually setting up Selinux or AppArmor profiles, and let's be real, most users aren't. Linux can be a bit more vulnerable in this case. The more likely risk is something called cross-site scripting, XSS. Here, a hacker tricks a website into executing code in your browser. For example, if Google had a vulnerability, I could potentially send you a Google link that extracts your Google session, allowing me to hijack your account. Luckily, most big sites are good at preventing XSS attacks, and even if you're worried, simply using incognito mode or a secure browser like Tor will add an extra layer of protection. Generally, clicking a link alone is more about privacy invasion, like tracking and fingerprinting, than outright hacking. If you're really cautious, use a VPN to mask your IP and maybe an incognito window to prevent XSS. For the extreme cases, consider using a privacy-focused browser or even a virtual machine for untrusted sites. Before we wrap up, I want to remind you about something that could seriously level up your hacking journey. Our community isn't just about learning, it's about growing together as hackers. If you're tired of feeling like you're doing it all alone, this is the place for you. We've got courses that break everything down step by step, resources you won't find anywhere else, and a group of passionate, like-minded hackers who are always ready to help. It's all about lifting each other up and learning together. If you're looking for more than just a course and want a real community where you'll never be stuck, come join us. Click the link in the description to be part of something great. That's it for today's tour of link-clicking paranoia. If this helped or gave you ideas for better online habits, please give it a like and subscribe. Drop a comment below if there's something you want me to dive into next. Catch you later.